heart is one of the most important organs in our body, because without it, we wouldn't be alive. It consists of four main chambers: the left atrium, the left ventricle, the right atrium, and the right ventricle. The ventricles are the two muscles in the heart, which pump blood to certain areas around the body. We start in the left atrium, where blood passes through the mitral valve. It then flows to the left ventricle. This contracts to pump blood past the aortic valve, and this valve divides the left ventricle to the aorta. The blood cells then enter the bloodstream, and the course it takes is completely random for each cell. The blood travels through arteries until it reaches a capillary. A capillary is the smallest blood vessel in the human body. As a red blood cell passes through it, it must squeeze through one at a time. This shows the importance of its elasticity. This is where oxygen and food nutrients are extracted and absorbed into the tissue within a capillary cell. Carbon dioxide is then absorbed back into the red blood cell, making the cell look a dull red. Capillaries are connected to veins, allowing waste to be transferred from the cells into the blood. The red blood cell then continues its journey through venules and then into veins. It flows back to the right side of the heart and enters the heart through both the superior vena cava and the inferior vena cava. The blood is now inside the right atrium and flows down through the tricuspid valve and then into the right ventricle. The tricuspid valve makes sure that the blood is moving in the right direction. The blood is now pumped back out of the heart past the pulmonary valve and through the pulmonary artery towards the lungs. Capillaries inside the lungs lie next to extremely thin membranes, which make up of millions of air sacs. As we inhale, fresh oxygen fills up the air sacs. As the red blood cell passes an air sac, oxygen, which has dissolved into the plasma, latches onto the cell. At the same time, carbon dioxide is released back into the air sac to be removed from the body. The cell turns a brighter red and begins its return to the heart. It enters back into the heart through the pulmonary vein and into the left atrium. We are now back to the start and have completed the journey of a red blood cell. This process is repeated in every part of the body until the red cell dies. Before we finish, a few definitions should be covered. Firstly, blood pressure. Blood pressure is the measuring of fluid pressure in the circulatory system. There are two types of pressure involved in this. They are diastolic pressure, a form of pressure generated by contraction, and diastolic pressure, the pressure between contractions. The equipment you see being used on this cartoon is equipment that we use to measure blood pressure. This could either be a stethoscope or a sphygmomanometer. Finally, pulse. A pulse can be felt where an artery lies close to the surface of the skin. The impulse is the expansion and contraction of the artery walls from the heart beating. This pulse is formed from the impact on the aorta when the heart beats. This creates a wave that continues along the artery. All arteries do have a pulse, but we humans can only feel the vessels that are closer to the surface of our skin. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Goodbye.